Tornadoes come in various shapes and sizes. The stovepipe is stout with straight sides. The rope tornado is slender and veers away in its late stages. The wedge tornado, wider than it is tall, has more contact with the ground and tends to be the most destructive of them all. The twister that sped through Xenia was a wedge tornado. But even the wide swath of destruction, characteristic of its shape, doesn't fully explain the impact of Xenia's tornado. And there is another anomaly. The pattern of destruction in Xenia doesn't seem to follow any logic. One house or building might be spared, while another, right next to it, lay in ruins. 15-year-old Bruce Boyd's Super 8 movie of the traveling storm proves to be an invaluable tool for world-famous meteorologist Dr. Theodore Fujita. It helped to determine several variable forces contributing to the effective destruction caused by Xenia's tornado and others like it.
Back in 74, you didn't have the kind of every person owning a video camera like you have now. So it was pretty rare to actually see movie footage of tornadoes, and especially ones like this one that had multiple funnels. And secondly, this was a debris-filled tornado. All of those little tracers would enable Dr. Fujita to make calculations of the tornado wind speeds, or at least estimates of the tornado wind speeds. The debris doesn't move exactly with the wind in the tornado, but it's as good an approximation as we can get.
By visibly capturing the inner workings of the wind tunnel, Bruce Boyd's film lent critical support to a controversial theory held by Dr. Fujita that individual suction vortexes within large tornadoes account for much of their destructive power.
This was tremendous find for Dr. Fujita, as it proved that suction vortices exist. There was a lot of skepticism in the meteorological community at the time about whether you could have multiple funnels revolving so close together about a parent tornado. Now, it's these suction vortices, when they happen to hit a location, hit a building, it gets hit a lot worse. When they lift and you see how quickly they're forming and dissipating, the places that didn't get hit by one of those suction vortices then has less damage. That was part of the mystery of this Xenia tornado, the hit or miss nature. Some houses spared, others totally destroyed. When Dr. Fujita zoomed in very carefully, you could actually see two funnels right in there twining about each other. This is the time of its greatest destruction. And this is the Xenia tornado. This is likely to be taking place in some of the F5 regions that were hit, very possibly as it moved through the Arrowhead subdivision.